Hello everybody and welcome to video number 32 of the online version of the Fusion Research Lecture. We are in chapter 6, Turbulent Transport, and in the last video we basically talked about turbulent transport in neutral fluids and showed some examples and introduced the Navier-Stokes equation and the Borgers equation being similar to the 1D Navier-Stokes equation without a pressure gradient term. Now, in this video, we will have a look at the energy transfer between different scales, different size scales. So we will have, to be more specific, an overview over eddies and the energy cascade. Eddies being flow vortices, as you remember. So let's have a look at eddies and the energy cascade. Okay, so let's assume we start with some large eddy by either stirring a tank or having a large scale instability. So let's try to draw one large eddy, maybe something like this. Oops. And just to indicate, this is something which we steer, we draw it like this. So this is now supposed to be an eddy. And now let's probably write down that we start here. So this is starting by either stirring a large tank, the fluid in a large tank, or we have some large scale instability. And what then happen is what you have probably seen already in the pictures I've shown, the photographs or in simulations, and you know that this large scale eddy decays into smaller scale eddies, for example like this. So let's try to indicate that by putting them down here, and then two eddies, we have another one here. And then that these eddies again decay into smaller sized eddies, for example, like this. Oops. Like this. Then let's make one more cascade. Like this, even smaller. Then each of the eddies decays into such two eddies. So this is something which we have basically seen in the photographs we looked at or in the simulations. And what now finally happens is, so what then eventually happens, of course, they cannot be infinitesimally small. Eventually the energy will be dissipated. So dissipation will happen here. Dissipation by viscosity, by inner friction of the system, by viscosity. And so in this direction, basically, so going downwards, this corresponds to how the energy flows. So this is the direction of the energy flow, meaning we start with some large scale eddy, this one here, which then decays into smaller scale eddies like this one, and into smaller scale eddies, and so on until the energy is dissipated by viscosity. So now to describe that in a bit more detail, what we want to look at is the energy transfer between different spatial scales. So we are interested in the energy transfer between different spatial scales. And that is basically a turbulence energy spectrum, what we want to look at, a turbulence energy spectrum. And a very famous one for turbulence in neutral fluids is the so-called K41 theory. And it is named according to Kolmogorov, according to Kolmogorov, who published this in 1941. And what did he do? So he looked at the spectrum, meaning we have here one axis, which is the, in logarithmic units, the energy density, log E. So this corresponds to the energy density, which is proportional to the square of the velocity. And then in this direction, we have the spatial dimension. So, also in logarithmic units, the wave number, which is the inverse of the wavelength. So usually we use wave number, space here. And then we start somewhere with injecting energy into the system. So here we have somewhere is the injection range, where we basically inject energy into the system, for example, by instabilities, or usually by some type of instabilities. For example, a Rayleigh-Taylor instability or Kevin Helmholtz instability. And then the energy decays, so the structures decay. So here we have in this representation a linear slope, something like this, and this corresponds to how the energy flows. So this is the flow of the energy, and this is called the inertial range. Called the inertial range, where we have this direct or such a direct cascade. A direct cascade, meaning that the energy is transferred from large scale eddies to smaller ones. This is why it is called in generally a direct cascade. So direct refers to the energy being transferred from large scale eddies to smaller ones. And now the interesting point is that this slope, slope follows the equation k to the power of minus 5 over 3, and that is a universal law. So there is something very interesting. And finally, if the structures are small enough, we have the dissipation range. So this is the dissipation range, where the energy is transferred into heat. So here we have transformation usually by inner friction into heat. And this is the K41 theory. And let's try to write that down in some words, in some sentences. So what we have just seen is that in 3D neutral fluid turbulence, which is supposed to be homogeneous, so the turbulence is supposed to be homogeneous and isotropic, so spread out over the whole system, And in such a system, the energy is transferred between self-similar eddies, so flow vortices, along a so-called direct cascade, from large to small scales. From large to small scales. Following the law where the energy density being proportional to k to the power of minus 5 over 3. And this is observed, since we are talking, as I said, about 3D neutral fluid turbulence, observed in gas and fluid systems, gas and fluid flows. And so let's just highlight it. We have a 3D system, 3D neutral fluid turbulence. We have a direct energy cascade here, a direct cascade, where the energy transfer is described by this law. And this is basically one of the most celebrated results in turbulence theory due to its universal character. Yeah, so this is a very important result here. Now, what about 2D turbulence? So let's talk about 2D turbulence. For example, thinking of a magnetized plasma, because in a magnetized plasma, the turbulence is not isotropic in all three dimensions. The turbulence is not, we rather underline that here, is not isotropic in all three dimensions due to the magnetic field, which imposes a certain preferential direction. So parallel to the magnetic field, we have the thermal movement, whereas perpendicular to the magnetic field, we have the drifts. And so this, there's a difference. Now, how does the corresponding spectrum look like? So if you again plot the energy density on this axis, so in logarithmic units, the energy density, and here the size, again in logarithmic units, so logarithmic units. And then if we have some injection range here, so this is supposed to be the injection, this is where we inject our energy. Injection. Then we have now two processes going on. We have a transfer to larger scales and one to smaller scales. And this is the energy cascade, an indirect energy cascade going upwards, and in this direction, this is the entropy here. The entropy, which we will define in a minute. The inverse energy cascade has a slope of k to the power of minus 5 over 3, as we have seen it before. And the entropy cascade now has a slope of k to the power of minus 3. Now, what is the entropy? So to define the entropy, we first have to define the vorticity. The vorticity corresponds basically to the strength of the spinning of a vortex. It's defined by capital omega, then the rotation of the velocity. So it corresponds to the strength of the spinning of a vortex. Then the entropy is basically corresponding to the energy, so it is the average over the squared of the vorticity. So this roughly corresponds to the energy. And these two quantities are conserved quantities in 2D turbulence, like the energy usually. Okay, so let's write down what we have in for 2D turbulence. In 2D turbulence, we have a dual cascade. In 2D turbulence, a dual cascade is observed in 2D turbulence. So we have on one hand side the inverse energy cascade. We have on one hand side the inverse energy cascade. And if you might wonder, the infrared catastrophe is avoided due to the interaction with the vessel wall. So finally, if the structure become too large, they just interact with the vessel wall and dissipate the energy in that way. So the infrared catastrophe, similar or not too different to the ultraviolet catastrophe and the Rayleigh-Jeans law from the black body emission, which was avoided by introducing discrete energy particles, right? So the infrared catastrophe here is avoided due to the eventual interaction with the vessel at too large structure sizes, corresponding to a small case, at too large structure sizes, corresponding, of course, as you know, to too small k's. And then, in addition to the inverse energy cascade, we have the direct entropy cascade. The direct entropy cascade. And this is what is observed in 2D turbulence. And as I said on the previous slide, this is what we expect for plasma turbulence. So this is expected for plasma turbulence since the drift velocity, the drift of the perturbed quantities, so due to an initial perturbation of the density, for example, perpendicular to the magnetic field, since this has a 2D nature. Okay, that is important to be aware of, that the 3D spectrum looks different from the 2D spectrum. That in a plasma, in a magnetized plasma, we expect more the 2D case. Now, if you want to simulate turbulence in magnetized plasmas, there are multiple codes to do that, multiple ways to do that. Relatively well, the oldest one probably is to use the two fluid model. The two fluid model to describe plasma turbulence. And the fluid is here assumed to be in local thermodynamical equilibrium, and the input parameters for that are a continuity equation, then B, the momentum equation, and then C, the energy equation. So making use of the conservation laws here of continuity, of mass basically, of momentum and of energy. And this is what I think you should have talked about in plasma, or will talk about in plasma physics 2 lecture. And the source of free energy, so the plasma is described by this using the two fluid model. And then what you use as a source of free energy is a pressure gradient. So this is the source of free energy, which creates instabilities, as you might know, instabilities. And these instabilities will finally lead to turbulence, as we will discuss in the next video. Okay, so this video was about eddies and the energy cascade. We looked at two different cases, a three-dimensional neutral fluid case, where we have the K41 theory applying, We have an energy, a direct energy cascade going from larger scales to smaller scales until the energy is finally dissipated due to viscosity, inner friction. And then the 2D turbulent case, the 2D turbulence case, which more corresponds to a magnetized plasma because the magnetic field imposes a certain preferential direction. There we have an inverse energy cascade and a direct entropy cascade. And then here I've just given an example, probably the oldest, certainly the oldest model, how to describe plasma turbulence by applying the two fluid model using the conservation laws as I've written down it here, and then taking the pressure gradient as a source of the free energy, which creates instabilities, which then lead eventually to turbulence. Okay, that's it for this video. Hope to see you in the next video.